Well, adventures, we are in a old west town, Oatman, Arizona. It's a very famous old town here, a mining town in Arizona. And the one key thing that you always see when you come to Oatman is the burros. Would you like to say hello? Hey, buddy. Are you a pretty good buddy? You like cameras? You just got them everywhere. They swarmed the truck whenever I came up. And they are just absolutely just roaming wild here. They're just as friendly as they can be. We're going to take this little walk around Oatman while we're here. Skim around, let you see a little bit of it. Some type of A-frame house up on top of the hillside. I guess they've got the best view in town. You got an old schoolhouse, 1900 schoolhouse over here. There's a Hollywood movie set. And we're going to walk around a little bit and see what else we've got for Oatman. And I'll carry you along on the journey. Whole hassle of them walking through here. It's like they swarm every new car that pulls up. I guess they think we've got food or something. Pretty freaking awesome. Just never knew that things like this still existed in the United States. It's definitely well worth getting off the beaten path, off the interstates, and see what you've got, because I tell you, it's amazing looking at some of the things that I'm seeing on this trip so far. It's absolutely hilarious as far as a sign I'm fixing to show you in the back. Saving your ass with a picture of a burro. You can't beat that, I tell you. Some of the humidity, the humor that you see in these old towns is just unbelievable. There's actually an Oatman Hotel that is still here, still in operation. I wish it was time of day that I could see about checking in, but unfortunately, or fortunately, I guess I should say, it's early in the day, and that's fine. We've got plenty more things to see and plenty more things to do here. Looks like an interesting spot to come into here just a second. Off to the side, they've got native touch herbs and rocks and local mine gem panning and all sorts of good stuff. And they've even got a mine museum that we're fixing to go into here in just a second. Not sure how good the lighting will be, but we'll give it our best shot. And here on the side, we've even got an old safe that you can go into. Got all sorts of cool knickknacks and paddywhacks and bowls and antlers and any number of different things in here. It's definitely an old safe. It's extremely hard and durable, I'll tell you that for it. And here you've got one of the old-fashioned early jail cells that they used out here in the West just to hold you for a little while till they figure out what they're going to do with you. You've got the peephole there, pass the food through. You've got Elvis out here in the old West. Fixing to enter the mine museum here. Hopefully the camera will focus. Gotta wash the head. Got the old fuse box there, the old lamp with the belt style battery, hard hats. Pretty interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, there's wildlife.
Wildlife? got a burro in the mine. I guess he wanted to go mining today or get off in the cool maybe. Maybe he's pretty smart. Walking up to the burrow, which you can possibly see the outline of here, but it doesn't look like this mine goes very far back, but that's all right. It's pretty cool to walk inside of, literally cool, because of the temperature, actually about 70 some odd degrees. Low humidity today here, so it's pretty cool. And we're exiting into the mine. Pretty interesting little quick tour. Got more displays around this side. Oatman was the ghost town that refuses to die. World War I was funded partially by the gold out of these mountains in 1912. Oatman boomed from 1910 to the 1920s, upwards to 8,000 people. People lived here. Gold mines were closed about 1942. Mines were needed to mine the copper for the world. War II, Blue Ridge Camp was renamed Oatman in 1909. And the 2,400 mile Route 66 winds from Chicago to Los Angeles. 1990 gold road mine reopened. Gold prices went down in 99. Mine closed in 2010 and reopened again. And we are here visiting it. And it goes through and talks about the burros can smell water 20 miles away. We carry our babies for 11 months. We first came to open with early day prospectors hauling rock and ore inside the mines. Outside the mines, we haul water and supplies. And as the mines close, we're released into the hills of Oatman. Our average lifespan is about 30 to 35 years. And they are absolutely just as friendly as they can be. All sorts of, once again, things that you would never imagine still existed in the U.S. We are seeing them today. It's been one of the high points of my tour, my trip that I wanted to come see is Oatman, and I am living the dream adventures. Get off your couch, get out of your comfort zone, and get out and see old America, how America was founded. The people that suffered and sacrificed to give us what we have today lived in these small towns like this, working their tails off every day. And we're gonna walk on up the main drag, main street here in Oatman, and see what else we can run across right here. Adventurers, we're fixing to go in the Oatman Hotel. A gift shop, ice cream shop, all sorts of good stuff in it. And there's a special treat I'll show you whenever we get upstairs. We're gonna walk in now and see what we can find. Cash register. Display cases. And we got a gift shop, museum, restaurant, and bar. Hotel's the oldest two-story adobe building in Milo County. Biracial with the National Historical Society. And looks like Clark Gable and Carol Lamar spent their honeymoon upstairs March 18th, 1939. And they frequently returned because they enjoyed the solitude and the hard tech, played cards with the miners. And there's a lot more history here that we can look at as we go around. And this is the bar that you put your dollar bill or whatever bill you want to on the wall, sign your name. And the place is pretty awesome. We're gonna walk upstairs here and see what we can find as far as museum items. And this is just one of the most interesting places I've ever been, just to be honest with you. And we're going up to the, what used to be the hotel at one time. And we're gonna walk around and see what we can find. And it looks like here's the room. Number 15. Carol LeBarn and Clark Gable spent their night here. Just look at that.
That is the honeymoon suite where Carol Lombard and Clark Gable stayed in 1939. They actually got married in Kingman, Arizona, and stayed the night down here in 1939.
Fantastic. Anything else you'd like to tell me about the hotel?
Basically, at the same time, we also had 17 rooms when it was a functioning hotel. Okay. We've taken out a few of the rooms and made it an antique place, and we also have a gift shop over here, too. So.
Fantastic.
And then when you go back downstairs, if you cut to the right, there's a wall right there, and that's one of our history walls. There's a lot of articles and different things about the history, too.
Now I have to leave my dollar.
Okay. So, yeah, put your name on the dollar and try and find a spot to put it.
There you go.
Running out of spots, but, yeah, that's another thing we're famous for,
yeah,
too.
What's your name?
Tracy.
Mark.
Nice.
Good
nice
to meet you,
Mark.
Tracy.
Me too.
Definitely appreciate your time.
Yeah, thank you. No time.
Walk around, let you see a little bit more of it. This was one of the rooms at 19. The rooms back in the day were pretty small, but that didn't take much for you to spend the night in these places. Hey, this is a neat little room. Got the Indian chiefs in here, sitting in their rockers, just taking it easy. Really, really cool. Old water fire extinguisher. I have no idea what that thing is, but it's pretty nifty.
Or is that just this one's clear?
Look at those old vending machines there. The little nut hut. I'm a mixed nut, I guess, so that works out pretty good. And there's the old Sioux City sarsaparilla. If you've never had a sarsaparilla, it's definitely well worth trying. They're like a root beer with a huge kick. Walk around, looks like we got one more room to look at here. Another one of the hotel. Rooms that have been broken up into just a huge gift shop area, and there's probably 3 to 4 rooms here that they knocked the walls out and expanded it out since this is not an operational hotel anymore. But we're going to walk back downstairs, adventurers, and see what we can find downstairs. Go next door to the bar, and there's a place you can actually, like I was telling you earlier, put your dollar bill on the wall, sign it, and put your dollar on the wall. So that's what we're fixing to do. Look at that old ice chest. It wasn't a refrigerator, you put a block of ice in it, and it helped keep your food cold for a while. You see what I'm talking about?
Do it all.
Dollars everywhere. There's a spot you can find to put one. You can definitely put one. And just look at this. Just keeps going and going and going. Even on the handrails. One of my adventure buddies put one somewhere here. Let's see if I can find it. I am not seeing it. We're fixing to put one ourselves up here in just a second. And there are dollars everywhere. You get rich just on the dollars put up here on the walls. Just look at this. Hello, ma'am. How are you doing today?
Hello. How are you?
I'm doing great. What's your name?
My name's Patty.
Patty Mark. Out on my old Route 66 journeys, and this is one of the spots I had to stop and see.
Cool.
Opening the mules or
the burros,
if you say it
yes. Correctly.
It looks like you got one eye out in the mine display back there. There's one in the mine. Display hiding out.
Is it really?
Yes, there was.
Nice.
Probably taking it easy.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about the place.
What would you like to know?
Whatever you want to tell me. You're in charge.
Hi. We have our dollars.
You definitely have the dollars. Yes. I'll tell you that much.
And it started with the miners. not having it, the bartender not giving them a tab.
Okay.
And so they would use a dollar with their name on it behind the bar as their tab.
Interesting.
And so that's how this got started.
A little tidbit of information. I appreciate it so much. I'm fixing to put my dollar up if I've got one to put up.
No worries. We got the markers and the staple gun right there.
All right. Let me see if we can do that. Appreciate you doing that.
It's crispy and our money's still here.
And where should we put it? Let's put it right by this browser. Fantastic. Thank you so much, ma'am.
You're very
I appreciate
welcome.
You so much.
$151,000
according to this gentleman, and there's my dollar. That's in Oakland, Arizona. How are you doing today, sir?
I'm doing fine.
Fantastic, sir. Well, that pretty well gives us a tour of the Oakland Hotel and the Oakland Bar. And we got a couple good interviews. I appreciate it. Talk at you in a little while there, Adventures. All right, Adventures, we're in one of the many, many gift shops along Oakland, Arizona. And inside this one, it's pretty cool from the outside. I thought I'd step in. They've got a sign museum of old signs and license plates, and old-fashioned gas pumps. If you remember the way these gas pumps used to work, you pumped a number of gallons up in the clear area to make sure you're getting all of what you paid for, and then it's a gravity fed back into your tank. Coke signs, and these are not replicas, these are actually the old real signs from back in the day off of the size of old gas stations and Texaco's and Chrysler Motor cars, old first motorized bicycles. And this one looks like it's had its better days, but you know, tell me how old this thing is. I don't see a date on it. I'd say that's probably back in the 20s or 30s range. That fire chief gasoline tank pump there is quite a bit newer. And I remember these, some of my family had stations. This little thing right here would actually twirl as you're pumping your gas, and gas would go through there. This is pretty cool. Look at that. There's my favorite car manufacturer, a beautiful Ford neon sign. Walk out into the gift shop here a little bit. All sorts of good stuff that I'm sure they've got. Top area. Nika Mala Watson's Harley inside the gift shop. Beautiful box. All the stoves. Butternut coffee can. Range you don't see very much of anymore. All those vintage cast iron plates and pans and skillets. Excuse me. Ventures, I was walking back out to my truck to leave my experience here in Oakland, and it looks like my truck is the draw for the burros. They are everywhere.
burrows everywhere and burrow poop everywhere. So you got to watch where you step around open Arizona, but that's okay.
You gonna walk one more place here before I head out? I'm gonna come over here and look at the schoolhouse. It was a Hollywood movie set according to the sign. We'll learn a little bit more about it here in just a second. It was actually the Gold City General Office. How the West Was Won, MGM movie in 1962, winner of 4 Academy Awards. John Ford, Henry Hathaway, and George Marshall were directors. And it had James Stewart, Debbie Reynolds, Carl Malden, George Peppard, Richard Widmark, and even the old Henry Fonda and John Wayne. Starring as General William Tecumseh Sherman and Gregory Peck and Spencer Tracy in the movie. I'm gonna pan around and let you see what the building actually looks like here. Pretty freaking interesting. And we got burrows that just swarm the place. Like they get looks like some of them are getting a little frisky with each other. Hopefully they don't get frisky with me, but I guess they're hungry, so I'm going to try to make it around them right here if we can without getting attacked by the wild burros. Bye bye, babies.